Black tee, black tee, black tan brown shoes.
People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of their skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. 9 4 9, a 2 4 2. Vote for me and I'll set you free.
Rock on, brother, rock on.
But the only person talking about love is a preacher, and it seems the only person concerned with earnings and teachers. The pollution and no solutions is killing my brothers. Disillusioned by the confusion of new shit.
Black tea,
round
black
and around we go. Where the world's headed, nobody knows.
Black tea, black tea,
round
black
and around we go. Where the world's headed, nobody knows.
Black tea, black tea,
round
black
and around we go. Where the world's headed, nobody knows.
Black tea, black tea, black tea.
Black tea and brown sugar.
Black tea, black tea, black tea.
Black tea, black tea and brown sugar.
Black tea, black tea, black tea.
Black tea and brown sugar.
Black tea, black tea.
Here to teach, spill, you already know the deal. Truth happened in the world. No, it's gonna be revealed. Clean version, dirty version. Yes, you gon' get it all. And the chips lay where they fall. We ain't being coy, shy, or abusive. Simply here to speak the truth and live. Not but that exclusive. Bringing to life things happening in the black community is what you're drinking. And we ain't even Georgia. Sit back, relax, and get your mind stimulated by the realness of the talk. Taking a journey, babe. On a type of different things and really living the same. Every time deliver something,
black tea,
something like fire. Yeah, that S word. You know who I be and where I be, it ain't a mystery. And if you don't know, then soon you will see. So in the meantime, get a coffee seat and empty cup and let us fill you up with that.
Black tea and brown sugar.
Black tea, black tea.
Yo, 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 yo! What's going on, everyone? Can I hear you? Can I hear you? Mm. We live? Live in the rain?
We live, baby.
What's going on, man? We here. We here giving everybody a chance to log on. And y'all make sure y'all share the video. Like and share. Like and share. Now, man, y'all share the video, man. Make sure y'all share the video. What's going on, Koya? What's going on, Naomi? Yeah, put sharing button. We got people all on, man. Y'all say what's up.
Let me know,
Shanika.
What's going on, Shanika?
Just refresh your home.
What's up, Sequoia?
Bow. Bow. Bow.
Got it.
Yeah, that's so embarrassing.
I mean, I'll just take now. That happened every time, man. How y'all feeling, man?
Happy Friday.
It is
Friday evening.
Tired.
Man, we made it another week.
Tired.
First week in April.
Stress.
These are going by so quick.
Trees, hey.
Hey, the trees.
Son on key. I better come through popping on, man.
What's up, Shunisha?
Let's go ahead and get the show started, man.
Right. That's her name, man. What's up, Tonya?
It's Tanya, man.
Tanya.
Tanya would go off.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We got to get her name wrong, man. She one of our faithfuls, man. She one of our faithfuls.
You better learn how to announce your name.
So, glad to be off work.
So check this out, y'all. This is our this is the sub show to Black Tea and Brown Sugar, man. This is our victory show. I will not be on here. We have wonderful people that's going to be hosting this show every other Friday. Be ready to be inspired, man. We got some great things coming.
I'm sorry, Tanya.
I told you, Tanya, don't play, man.
Look.
I I got the business too, man. So
what's up, Miss Amber?
So yeah, we're gonna leave the show to them, man. Y'all make sure y'all every other Friday, 7:30, 6:30 Central. Make sure y'all tune in Sunday for me and Key, 7:30, 6:30 Central, and be great, baby. Ashley and Marcus, y'all got it.
All right. So
Pittsburgh, how y'all doing?
What's up?
We here now. Long time coming. First and foremost, man, I just want to thank everybody for tuning in. Want to thank everybody that's been following I just want to thank everybody that's been following me and Ash, man. We've been on about a 3-year hiatus.
Four years.
Hiatus, you know what I'm saying, from the hip hop shop. So now, you know what I'm saying, thank God, you know what I'm saying, we transferred to a new platform, the Friday Night Victory Show. You know what I'm saying? From as of right now, you know what I'm saying? We'll be doing this every other Friday. So from now on, it won't be next Friday, but it'll be the Friday after. If there's any changes or anything like that, you know what I'm saying? We will definitely let y'all know, keep y'all posted. You know what I'm saying? Introduce myself. My name is Mr. Marcus.
I'm just going by Ash for right now.
I'm Mr. Marcus Dodney.
Mr. Marcus.
Marcus Dodney. you can anybody follow me on social media? You can follow me on Instagram at hey_Mr. That's MISTA _ Marcus, MARCUS. And that's on Instagram. My Twitter page is Hi Mr. Marcus. So that's HI_MISTA_MARCUS. You forgot your stuff.
Okay. For the record, I'm hardly also. I like stuff, but I don't even know my name. But I'm Asher's ASHHERS 1115. And that's on Twitter and Instagram. So let's get started.
All right. So you want to get straight into it?
Hey, I mean, what's this week's highs and lows? I know for me, I made it through another week. Super duper busy, but you know, God be the glory, you know.
Yeah.
Made another week between, you know, regular daytime job, school, church, you know.
I think the honest highlight for me this week, honestly, was getting back to this.
Point of victory. We want this to be an uplifting, you know, broadcast every Friday, talk about our highs, you know, the positive things that took place. I mean, there's enough drama and trouble in itself in the world each day that goes past. You can't log on the internet without anything negative going on. So
right.
We want to put a spin on that Friday, you know, Friday evening.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, pretty much, it's just that end of the week, you know what I'm saying? Especially, you know, us having our, you know what I'm saying, Christian faith or whatever, you know.
It ain't an or whatever.
No, it's not or whatever, but just saying, you know, is what we do, you know, as far as, you know, going to church on Sunday, that's kind of preparing us, you know what I'm saying, to go out throughout the rest of the week and work, you know what I'm saying, and do everything, you know what I'm saying, that, you know, God is expecting us to do, so. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty much, you know, this show, you know what I'm saying? I want y'all to look at it like a release. You know what I'm saying? Definitely, we'll be doing a lot of other things on the show. We will be broadcasting very, very soon. Businesses, black-owned businesses.
Yes.
Anybody that's doing anything, any type of stores, just now starting your businesses up, we will have that type of stuff on here. We think it's very important to uplift and promote, you know, black-owned businesses, especially living in Pittsburgh, you know, when, you know, there's a very lack of that. So we will be having guest speakers here. We will be having, you know, giving you guys an opportunity to call in, you know, talk about your issues. And most important part of the evening is our nightly topic, you know what I'm saying? And we want y'all to, you know, definitely comment, you know what I'm saying, call in. Once again, if you did not get the phone number, once again, it is 412-376-5180. And pretty much, you know, just go ahead and just comment and let us know that you want to call in, you know what I'm saying? Or you can text that number, you know what I'm saying? We'll actually go ahead and give you a call.
So we're gonna have our first victory conversation. Let's see.
Hello.
Hey, happy Friday.
Hi.
Hey. How you doing?
What's going on?
Nothing. Chilling. Waiting for you.
So, we're going to jump. So, we're going to jump right into it. Right? So, you have the victory. Please share with viewers, with listeners, why do you have the victory?
Okay, great. Okay. I want to start by saying I thank God for being alive, because there's been plenty of times that I could have been dead and gone from sickness to being shot. You know, there's been plenty of ways that I could have been taken out by the enemy, but God had another purpose for me, so I'm still here, and I just want to thank God for that. I was diagnosed with cancer, with skin cancer, probably sometime in July of 2016.
Wow.
And when they told me that, you know, it was kind of, I was thinking, like, nobody in my family has cancer. So, you know, I was like, well, maybe it could have been on my dad's side. You know, I don't really know my dad, so I don't really know. So, yeah, I was, you know, I was scared. I was nervous, you know, even though, you know, I knew who I served, I knew that God could do anything. But at the same time, I'm human. God gave me these feelings. So at times, I tend to show those feelings. And at that time, I showed those feelings. I was down. I was depressed. I was like, God, why? Why is this happening? You know, and that was during the first stage of it. And then, you know, I thought that everything was going well. And then more marks started to show up on my body. And it'll start as a red mark, and then it will turn dark. So it'll leave like dark marks on the skin because of skin cancer. So during that, you know, still going through the sadness and everything like that. And then, you know, I've just been looking forward to the day where I can walk into the doctor's office and say, and leave and say, I'm cancer free. So I'm here it is, you know, I got diagnosed July of last year. So, you know, around January, I'm like, come on, God, what's going on?
Right.
I said, what's going on, God? Like, talk to me, like, you know, I'm not sure what's going on because, you know, I'm scared now because, you know, you grew up to know that cancer kills people most of the time. So when you think of cancer, you automatically panic. You know, your family panics. Everybody's like, oh, my gosh, you might die, you know. But after that stage, finally I got to my last doctor's appointment. And for some reason, I woke up that day and I just knew, like, I just knew that it was the end. You know what I mean? Like, it was the end. Like, I was not going to be sick anymore. There was not going to be any issues. I just had that feeling. So I was like, okay, well, I know the Bible says what a man thinketh, so is he.
Yes,
so I'm like, okay, well, you know, I mean, okay, I'm going to go in here. You know, I'm like, cause I've been this plenty of times, you know. But I was like, I'm going to go in there, and then I'm going to walk out cancer free. You know, I'm practicing it like, okay, I'm going to walk in there slow, and I'm going to walk in there fast. I might just walk sideways. I don't know, you know. And so I go to the doctor's appointment. I walk in. I'm nervous. I'm shaking. Like, I'm shaking. Even though my brain is saying, okay, son, you got this. You got this. You got this. Just, you got to believe. You got to believe. You got to have faith. Faith is what I want to say. You got to do your job too, Felita. So I went in there, they did the checkup, and they had to run an exam, you know, to see how everything was going. And I'm sitting in the room waiting because she's like, I will be right back. And kind of took forever. It felt like, you know, it might have been like 5 minutes, but it took forever for her to come back in that room. So I'm sitting there, I'm nervous. I'm like, God, I mean, let your will be done. If this is your will, then I'm going to have to just, I'm going to just have to live with it. I'm going to have to get my stuff together. I'm going to have to get right, you know. And so she comes back in the room and she's like, well, I want to say that you're cancer-free. Yes. And at first I thought she was joking. You know, I thought she was playing. I'm like, well, show me some paperwork, you know, because, and nowadays, you don't just go by what people say. They more so look at, okay, what you got to show for, like, as far as paperwork. You know? So I'm like, so what you mean? I thought she was playing, so I started laughing, and I was like, huh? And so she started to explain everything, and I'm just like, huh? She said, well, now I'll do it. Start over.
Yeah.
Because it's the fact that I woke up and I just had that feeling. And from me waking up, I just automatically, because I'm not going to say my faith is where it needs to be. Mm-hmm. But at that time, it was there.
Right.
It was all the way there. When I say it was there, it was there. Like, nobody could have had more faith than me that day. Because it was there. So, anyway, so she started explaining everything to me, and I'm just like, my mind is spinning. I ended up getting a headache. I started getting hot. I'm like, oh, my gosh. You know, and I'm just like, God, I just want to thank you.
Yes.
I just, you know, to some people, you never know how they are. So, you know, me saying it out loud, you know. So I kind of just was in my head like, Lord, I just thank you. Like, God, I just want to thank you. I want to first thank you for who you are. I want to thank you for what you're doing, what you're about to do. I thank you for not leaving me behind.
Mm-hmm.
I thank you for being that provider. I thank you for being that strength. I thank you for being that healer that
yes.
you are. I thank you for being the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega. I thank you. You know, I'm just doing it in my head. I'm just like crying, and I'm like I'm just happy. I was just happy. I was happy, and then I walked out of there just so relieved. Like, it felt like I had this infection. Like, I feel like I had, like, this, like, a toxic type deal, and it was real heavy on me. Like, it was heavy. Like, I was carrying it. Like, I was carrying it. It seemed like each day it got heavier because I started missing work from being sick.
Yeah.
You know, I was passing out.
Wow.
Uncontrollably, I didn't even. I could be having a normal conversation, and bam, I'm out. I'm
wow.
on the floor, and I come to, and everybody's in my face like, "Oh my God, what's up?" And I'm like, "Oh my God, what happened?" So, and then not too long ago, I had a seizure, which made it more serious. And then I just recently had an MRI. I'm still waiting on the results. So I was supposed to get that Wednesday, but I'm still waiting on them. So, but yeah, that was my victory, to say that I overcame cancer, not
yes.
just because I ate right or not because I drank water. It was because I believed that God would do it. I believe that God is who he says he is.
Right.
And he did it. He did it. And I can't, you know, people right now, you know, and during this time, you know, people are going back and forth like, you know, some people are with God, some people are against them. So it's like, nobody can tell me that God is not real.
Right?
That's right.
Yes.
Because he didn't done so much for me. Do you hear? So much. Years ago, I got sick. I got real sick, you know, and we didn't know what was going on. And my mom ended up taking me to the hospital, and come to find out, my appendix was about to explode. And they told me that when that happens, that's, you're out. There's no more Selena. There's no more any of that. You're gone. So it's like, it's so much been built. And I don't even know if we need it or anything. I'm just like confused because I was young.
Mm-hmm.
And, so after everything got done, the man, the doctor came in, you know, I was coming to, and he was just like, you know, he kind of just sat down and was, you know, you know how people get that, they're like, at first I didn't believe in God, mm-hmm. but I'm kind of starting to believe in him now, mm-hmm. now that I've seen this. You know what I mean? They give you that look, like, yeah.
yeah.
So he was just telling me, he was like, I don't know how to say this. I don't know how you're going to take this. But he said, you got here just the amount of time. He said, because when they took it out, and the moment they put it in the jar, it burst.
Wow.
So it was like everything was in the perfect timing. And my mom has even told me a million times, she said, Selena, that day you were sick, she was like, no, well, I don't have the insurance, so I can't really just, you know what I mean? I can't take her to the hospital because I don't have the money. So, well, let me give her this or let me give her a cocktail. You know, just trying to figure out what she can do. And then she finally was just like, you know what? I'm going to take you there because it's getting worse.
Mm-hmm.
And she took me there, and the amount of time God has been protecting me, when I say all my life, all my life, I know I have a purpose. Right. Here on this earth.
And you do.
And I know that I'm still here for a reason.
Right. So. And that is a lot to celebrate. You know, like God, like, man, I am celebrating. I thank God for your testimony. I thank God for even being able to meet you, you know, because that's powerful. Like a lot of us, you know, we doubt what God can really do because we don't see him or, you know, because of what we think society has to say. But man, God is definitely a healer. Thank you so much for your testimony and sharing with us.
No problem.
Yeah, that testimony.
When it comes
was...
down to God, you gotta come with it. You gotta let people know.
Yeah.
Times it's winding up.
Yes.
You know, if people don't realize it, you know, I'm gonna just be the one to say it. Time is winding up.
It is.
Yes. So
get yourself together.
The, not saying that the people that haven't read the Bible, you know, I'm not, you know, I'm gonna say, you know, saying that, but for those that know what the end of that Bible says,
mm-hmm.
we know time is winding up. So, you know, we got to let people know, you know, God is real and he is who he said he is.
Right.
Yes, he is.
You just got to believe. You got to have faith. You got to have faith. You got to believe. So...
Well,
but
Selena,
I appreciate you guys.
My pleasure. Thank you so much. And that really helped to close out my week too, man.
And also, I want to say something. You know, a lot of people just was on here commenting, and they everybody pretty much said they are praying for you and your testimony. You know, I'm getting texts and now, you know, people are just. You know, thank you so much, sister. I mean, you are a walking testimony, man. I mean, that is
no
phenomenal
problem.
Testimony right there, man. I mean, I'm trying not to get all teary-eyed and all that right now.
All right, Selena. All right. Well, thank you again, and have a good evening. Continue to watch the show, though, all right?
I will, definitely. Thank you.
My pleasure. All right.
All right, bye.
So real. I never understand how people don't believe in God. You know what I mean? Like, she ain't do nothing special but had faith. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what's important moving through. I mean, look at the man we call our president, the decisions that he's making that, you know, we're not in support of. And, you know, just seeing what's going on, you know, in our society, you know, there's a lot going on. And to not believe in God, man, that's a lonely world.
Listen, I tell people all the time, God will show you. He will show up and show out.
I agree.
More than anything, you know, it's not even a question. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I've seen plenty of brothers, you know, especially, I know last year, you know what I'm saying, like a lot of cats that I grew up with, was starting to come home from jail.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And a lot of them were struggling as far as, you know, finding jobs and so on and so forth, man. And I know in particular, my cousin, you know, he was just got to that point where, you know, he couldn't find a job. He was a felon.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? The type of stuff he had on his record, it was just real tough for him to really get any type of employment, good employment. You know what I'm saying? And I watched him go from, you know, coming home, being frustrated, taking it to God,
mm-hmm.
now, you know what I'm saying, his new car, new house. She only been home for a couple years, right? New car, new house. You know what I'm saying? Three books published. You know what I'm saying? At four books published, about to publish another one. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I've watched cats like that, you know, where society tell you there's no hope. You know what I'm saying? As hard as it is to get jobs out here for black men, you know what I'm saying? How God took his situation, said, I got you. You know what I'm saying? Just sit back and have some faith.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You know, I think we spend so much energy, you know what I'm saying, trying to fight for ourselves and trying to, you know, think that we could change it, you know what I'm saying? But a lot of times, man, God is really just saying, just sit back, you know what I'm saying, and just let him take control over the situation. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Just have faith in him, you know what I'm saying? And it's that simple. So, yeah, that was a
but good it brings
testimony.
Me, yeah, man. But it brings me, it's like, he... Marcus is emotional.
I'm emotional.
Out of the two of us, he's the sensitive one.
Whoa. Why you go from sensitive to emotional?
I mean,
it's a difference.
They work hand in hand.
Sensitive.
And you're both. Anyway.
Not sensitive.
Nah, but, I mean, while we're on the topic.
Yeah.
Today, I really want to bring up the role of a man. The role of a man. And I want to bring it up because it's one of those things, like, I don't think society, us blacks, Americans, we don't really truly realize like the role of a man. Mm-hmm. And I say that because, man, I be seeing and hearing some crazy stuff.
Yeah.
Like, okay, I know like in the news and on social media, you seen like the woman that was doing like the butt implants. She was claiming to be a doctor. And
oh, yeah.
And at the end of the day, and even watching TV, it's like, why are these ladies doing all of this to themselves, you know?
Right. What up, Chris? What's going on, brother?
And it's like, you know, what's the real reason behind doing all of this? I mean, God has blessed me abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
And he's blessed other women in other ways. It doesn't necessarily have to be, like, they're physical. But, I mean, if they don't have the body, they have the brains.
But it's deeper than that, though.
It is deeper than that. And that's what I want to talk about today. So
right now, so everybody, you know what I'm saying, you have the choice, you know what I'm saying, you can text if you want us to call. But if you're on the page right now, we would like to see what is your definition, you know what I'm saying? What is your definition of the role of what a man is supposed to be?
Right.
You know, whether you're using your own example, a TV example, you know, it could be biblical, non-biblical, you know what I'm saying? Whatever your view is, you know what I'm saying? What is your viewpoint of what a man is supposed to be? I got my viewpoint.
But I think this world is so messed up, and this is my opinion. This world is so messed up because we don't have men leading.
Well, here's what I honestly
believe. Like they should be, yeah.
I personally believe, you know what I'm saying? This is just me personally. I believe that if you don't know who Christ is, if you don't know what God considers a man to be, you can't possibly be a man. You know what I'm saying? I say the same thing about love. You know, if you don't know what that actual biblical definition of love is, then what's that?
My phone.
Oh, so you bugging.
I don't know how to use it.
But now that's my personal opinion. You know what I'm saying? I know everybody has their foundation. Sydney, what's up, little sis? I know everybody has their foundation, they have their viewpoint. Now, I'm gonna say this. I personally think that in today's society, men, I feel like it's been a role switch.
Yeah.
I feel like more men, in my opinion, have taken the roles of women, and I feel like a lot of women today are forced to take the roles of men. I'm starting to notice a lot of women that I meet, especially single black mothers, either the father's not there, you know what I'm saying, or the father is just not the head of the household.
And it goes deeper than just even black, because I've seen them white too. I mean, and I say in America, because you see a lot of times, like you said, the dad isn't there.
Right.
And I mean, a lot of dysfunction is created. And
right.
And what we mean by roles, let's clarify. We're not saying, oh, the woman should be in the house, sweeping the floor, cooking the dinner.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, the helpmate. And not help as if the woman is under the man, but the woman is supporting, standing next to the man.
Okay. So, Tanya said the role... I know her name now. Tanya, see how they try to play me? So Tanya said, the role of a man can be different things. Putting what a man should be in a box is one of the things that go wrong.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to touch on. Do you think men and women have switched roles in society? I mean, and it's, when I say roles, it's not, oh, like I said, so men gotta work.
So let me ask you this. Okay, so Tanya, so do you not, matter of fact, you know what? I think we should call Tanya. Tanya, if you would like to call in, please send us a text and then we'll call you. Because I got kind of rebuttal against that.
412-376-5180. We're not saying roles as in this is the masculine's role. Oh, he has to work 9 to 5.
A man well, should I mean, work. Yes,
he should be a provider.
See, now you see how quick yes. you switch that up?
Yeah, I'm not going to be with a man that's not a provider. My okay. father is a provider. My father is, and I just got done talking to my grandma about mm-hmm. this. My dad is an excellent dad, despite, okay. you know, the issues. We're human.
Okay.
But even when a man and a woman is to be a help to the man is to lead. This is what I mean.
I agree with that.
A man is to lead.
I agree with that. But, and well, not but, because I agree with that.
Tanya can't talk right now.
You can't talk. It's okay, Tanya. We'll still communicate with you through here. Listen, at the end of the day, I believe that a man has two jobs, to protect and provide. Now, let me clarify that. No, leading as well, but we I believe that a man is supposed to lead. But let me break down these two: protect and provide. Because I think a lot of people believe when they say protect, it's naturally a physical thing. When you're mm-hmm. talking about providing, it's financially. Mm-hmm. When I protect and provide for my daughter, me protecting her is not just, you know, protecting her from physical harm.
Mm-hmm.
It's mentally protecting her. You know what I'm saying? Spiritually protecting her, mm-hmm. which is teaching my daughter, you know what I'm saying, how we carry ourselves as Christians.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Teaching my daughter how a man is supposed to treat you. You know what I'm saying? I had this big thing with my daughter where she will not, for nothing, like, she's not opening up the door for herself if it's a man next to her. You know what I'm saying?
I had to. Either.
Right. But nowadays, there's not a lot of that going on. You know what I'm saying? But that's the whole thing, you know what I'm saying, with the whole teaching factor. And I'm saying this to say this. A lot of old school fathers that I know, that I've met, you know what I'm saying, especially through other relationships that I've been in with women, I've dated a lot of women who their fathers, their job was pretty much just to work, pay the bills, and that's it. There was very little interaction with their children. They was just working all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And me personally, don't get me wrong, I do agree that as men, we do have to work. But I'm going to tell you like this, man, it plays a big difference when you are actually in your children's lives, mm-hmm. man. You know what I'm saying? Especially, you know, just your wife itself. You right. know what I'm saying? That time being spent, seeing what's going on. I don't think it needs to just be, you know, just working and providing money.
All right.
Especially as black men. I think what we should do is we should definitely work hard, but I think every man should be working hard to put ourselves in a position where we don't have to work mm-hmm. no more to some degree.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Work as hard.
Right.
Right.
But I think it's a lack in the whole family structure mm-hmm. just as far as men. That's the first thing. Now, the second thing, let me keep it flat out. Men acting like...
Yeah. So we're agreeing. Wait, Alex, yes, I was saying, role of a man, overseer, strong vessel, the foundation builder, the protector, being the steady, stable, and I love the word consistent. Literally, talk to anybody I know. Consistent is my favorite word.
It's chivalry versus independence. Now, Esquire, when you say you like that mindset, which one? Because I'm seeing this is about to be a battle with the sexes, and you better be on my side, bro.
No.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just playing.
No, but it
okay.
is
okay.
chivalry over independence. At the same time, okay, like, I love to see a man that loves on his woman.
Okay.
And, like, I'm even in a relationship. I don't even have to think about, and, like, he already does it. He's two steps ahead. I don't right. even have to even look like I think like I'm tired.
Okay.
He knows I'm tired. And you know what? We're like, hey, I got something special for you today. What are we doing? I booked you a spa day.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
You right.
Dad, what? But, I mean, it's that type of nurturing that a woman needs from a man for that security.
Okay.
Aaron said a man's job is to lead, provide, protect, but you also have to be willing to lead as a woman.
Thank you, Aaron. I like your style, brother.
But that's the purpose of the woman being the helpmate. Because, Bible...
Yeah, but she must lead in being a woman.
But the Bible also speaks on this in the New Testament. The Old Testament. Let's look at the story of Adam and Eve. And okay. I'm not about to preach, but with Adam and Eve...
Yes,
with Adam and Eve, God created Adam first. He gave Adam a job. Adam was busy. It wasn't like Adam was just chilling back, eating some fruit, chilling in the garden.
He worked.
He was working hard.
But Adam was slipping as well.
He wasn't slipping. This was before Eve.
Okay.
So God was like, you know what? I need to give Adam a mate, a helpmate, an Ezer.
Now let's fast forward.
Okay, let's fast forward.
He
slipped because God gave him instruction on not to eat the apple.
But wait a minute. It was, whoa, you skipping.
No.
You want me to tell you how you skipping?
Okay, tell me.
What did God say to Adam? Adam, where were you?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, so let's talk about what really happened.
Okay, all right, fine.
I'm just saying.
Wait, let's go to the comments.
Wait a minute.
If
let's
you don't
skip.
Define a role... She said...
Hold on, wait. I don't want to skip, because they all came down the line. Start from Alex.
Okay, you read Alex.
Okay, Alex said, role of a man, overseer, the stronger vessel, the foundation builder, and protector. You read that?
Yeah.
Being the steady, stable, and constant.
You sure? Because I said I like the word consistency. Consistent is one of my favorite words.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yes.
So who was next? Ebony. I think the father can still be in the picture, but if he's not in the home, there will still be problems.
But you still, that is
I
true.
I agree with that 100%.
But you still have to let him lead because you chose him to be the father of your child.
Right. Well, wait a minute. She said, broken homes create brokenness. I don't care how well a single mother, thank you.
Yes,
holds the house down. I'm a little blind. Holds the house down and man is needed. And honestly, Ebony, thank you for saying that so much because I believe what's happening is because men are not doing their jobs, I do believe that women are being forced into taking on that extra role as being a father. I could look at it from my childhood, you know what I'm saying? You know, me and my brother's dad, you know what I'm saying? They were both, you know, weren't fully in, you know what I'm saying, me and my brother's life. And I personally know my mother, you know what I'm saying? She was mom. But she had two boys she had to raise.
Mm-hmm.
So there was mad times where I watched my mother had to step out of that mommy role and she really had to bounce into that father role. Mm-hmm. And the bad thing about it is, you know, I commend all women, especially black women, you know, for stepping into that father role. But ladies, these men, listen. Well, start suing these dudes for child support. Like, so, I'm not even playing. No. Listen, let me keep it 100. Yo.
You lost viewers on that one.
Listen, women, stop letting these dudes get off so easy, man. All right?
Hold them accountable.
Real talk. Sue them for child support. You know what I'm saying?
Make them come.
Drop the baby off over their house.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, black women, you can look your child in the face when they get older and they ask what happened between you and dad. You can say, baby, it didn't work out, but guess what? I tried.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I'm a single father. You know what I'm saying? You know, me and my daughter's mother, man, we got a tight relationship, man. You know what I'm saying? Best of friends. You know what I'm saying? We know our roles. We respect our roles. And let me tell you, man, I mean, there's been times where even when I feel like I'm falling off as a father, I've called my child's mother and said, listen, I've been slipping. I had some things going on. I'm sorry, but I will do better. Brothers, man, I think some of the sisters, man, they just want to see y'all at least trying, making
effort.
The effort. Mm-hmm. And honestly, y'all want to know what most of that effort is? Being there. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? They know how hard it is for some of us to find jobs. They know some of us been in the streets. We got records and all that. Being there is really like 75% of the battle, man. You know what I'm saying? She might still sue you for child support, maybe. But so what? That's your child, man. And that's what I think is missing a lot today that's going on with men, man. Men is not being men. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that comes from fathers not being in their lives. Men, I say it all the time, man. A lot of cats, man, I see so many women tendencies in men. You know,
it's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous, man. You know what I'm saying? It's out of control, man. So let me see.
Let's go through each comment.
Okay.
All right.
I need to finish my statement because it's important. So let me finish and then we can go through. Fact of the matter is, Adam wasn't watching his wife.
Adam was not watching his wife.
Okay. So you got to look at it like this.
He started off. As a consequence.
Right. But wait a minute. Hold on. Okay. He started off as a man.
Yes.
He was working. He got his wife.
Mm-hmm.
His wife slid off. First thing he did was he didn't correct his wife. Second thing he did, he should have been looking for his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Third thing, Adam, he was out there working. Now, you see what that all that hard work, which mm-hmm. is good, but God gave you that second responsibility.
Right.
So, in my opinion, the working is great. The hard work, trust me, I spoil my daughter. I love to spoil the women I'm with, you know what I'm saying, from my daughter, my mother, whatever woman I'm with at the time. Sorry, I'm just joking. It's like, no, I'm not. But, you know what I'm saying? I'm a spoiler. So I love to work hard. You know what I'm saying? I love to, you know, do all that type of stuff. But let me tell you something, man. My daughter, she's probably not going to remember them Jordans that I bought her a year ago.
And I told you about that.
But she's going to get real top. Because let me tell y'all, when I had my daughter, I was so worried about being a good father. This was my first child. And I was just nervous, you know what I'm saying? So
I'd be talking to him on the phone. He'd be like, yeah, I'm at the mom, but the dad, my daughter.
Because that's my baby.
Boots. I'm like, you just bought her boots last week. Yeah, but it's a good thing that, and I always commend Marcus on raising his daughter.
Right. You
know, she sees, like, he's not only her provider, he's her support, and girls need to see that from their dads.
Right.
I mean, even speaking from experience, I mean, I didn't get it until later on, but even just knowing I could pick up the phone, hey, dad, you know, like, it means a lot.
Right.
So,
What's up, Ro? What's up? Oh, your sister on.
Oh, hey, Camille.
What's up, sis?
Wait, Camille or Adrian? Okay, Camille. Hey, Camille.
But nah, man, I definitely been down that road as a black father, man. You know, I was worried about what everybody else was doing. And all I knew was what some of these older cats kept telling me was protect, provide, protect, provide. And I didn't have a full understanding of what providing meant. So I don't regret it because that's my baby. I'm still splurging on my daughter. But I was more focused on buying her Jordans. What's up, Ike?
Mm-hmm.
I was more focused on buying my daughter Jordans, you know what I'm saying? Buying her clothes, you know what I'm saying? Taking her to Chuck E. Cheese, you know what I'm saying, every other night. There's nothing wrong with that. But here's when I figured out, you know what I'm saying, that it was a whole new definition, you know what I'm saying, to what it meant to protect and to provide. You know what I'm saying? It came to a point where my daughter went down my house and we was chilling down there. And my daughter's room was set up, but it wasn't fully set up, you know what I'm saying? But I had it halfway. I had her bed set, but I didn't have her a mattress or whatever. So she was like, well, Daddy, I'm tired. I want to go home. And I said, well, you don't want to spend time with Daddy? She was like, Daddy, I do, but I'm tired. You know, I want to stay down at your house, but my bed's not down here. I was working so hard at that time, not even paying attention, you know what I'm saying? Not having certain conversations, you know what I'm saying, with my daughter, and that's what ends up happening. As fathers, we have to be there, man, especially with our little girls, mm-hmm. man. Especially, man, listen, real talk, almost every woman that I've dated, man, and it's not their fault, you know what I'm saying, to a degree, almost every woman I've dated had daddy issues. You know what I'm saying? A lack of that father being there. And it's not their fault. You know what I'm saying? But you got these little girls growing up, you know what I'm saying, in the world where you're supposed to have that balance, you know what I'm saying? Mommy's supposed to teach them how to be a woman. Daddy's supposed to teach them how a man is supposed to treat them. And they don't get that, you know what I'm saying, when the fathers is not in the play, man. It's very important, man. But
you also get that. You also get that with males in the opposite way.
Exactly.
Because you get, and I come across two different type of guys. You get the... No offense. No, not you. Who? But you get the type of guy that ends up being what we call the quote-unquote mama's boy and feels like he has to provide for his mother or be his mom's companion. And that becomes an issue when a woman is dating a man when he's always there for his, like, he's always doing for his mother.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with that. I actually... If the guy has a problem with his mother, like mm-hmm. a relationship problem with his mother, I want nothing to do with it.
Right. Have we been missing any, hey guys, if anybody has been calling or sending texts and we missed it, please comment under here that you're trying to get through and we will put you live on the line. Definitely. But matter of fact, actually right now, I'm not sure if still on the line, but we were actually going to call Miss Latrice Snead.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to go ahead and dial that number.
Wait, I think I closed it off. Shame on me.
So let me see.
I don't know why I'm acting like I don't know how to work the internet.
Real issues. Yo, Lonzo, you're funny, bro. Alex, man.
But no, I mean, it's real issues with males and females when the dad isn't present, because when the dad isn't there, especially, and I've also seen with guys too, they don't really truly know how to treat women.
Right. What's up, DC? What's good, bro?
He shouting out all his homies.
I got to, man. I got to show love. I ain't even do that. Shout out to the whole Hill District.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, I got to do that.
I'm not affiliated, you guys.
I'm affiliated Hill District. You already know.
All right. So, Latrice, how are you?
Miss Latrice, how you doing?
I'm good. How about you guys?
Oh, pretty good. Can't complain. So, we're sitting here having a conversation. So, we would like to get your opinion on... You know, what do you see? Do you think this is like a just a huge, you know what I'm saying, epidemic? Or, I mean, what do you think just this whole situation is for the roles of a man and the effects, excuse me, that it has on the family and so on and so forth? I mean, what's your viewpoints on this?
Well, the first thing that I can say is that, from some of the conversations that you guys are having, let's go to the part of, you know, when a father is missing out of a child's life.
Mm-hmm.
That plays a big part, and a lot of people don't realize that when the father isn't around, you know, especially for little girls, they go searching for love in all the wrong places.
I agree.
They go from, you know, going to dealing with multiple guys and, you know, wanting to have sex and wanting to have that love and attention, and because they never got it from their father, they mm-hmm. never got that, you know,
princess, that
daddy loves you, mm-hmm. and, you know, so on and so on. So they go looking for love in other places, and in all reality, they end up getting hurt, you know, because what they want from their father, they couldn't get, so they try to get it from a man when a man may not even be wanting to do that or see it in that type of way. Mm-hmm. So then they turn, you know, cold-hearted and bitter, you know, yeah. because they end up being used, abused, and hurt.
So.
Same thing as far as a male perspective also. If that little boy doesn't have his father around, you know, he goes looking out for, you know, most of them get off the porch. They end up going into the streets and stuff because they're looking for that love and that bond mm-hmm. from other people that mean no good to them.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
It's real.
You know,
it's real. Yeah.
It really is. It really is. You know, I'm a single parent. It's hard. You know, it really is.
Mm-hmm.
It really is. My father wasn't around in my life. You know, I just reunited with my father, and it wasn't the what I expected, you know what I mean? But I did it because I'm 31 years old, and that's something that I really wanted.
Right.
You know, I was okay with dealing with, you know, if it was a good thing or if it was a bad thing, but it was so, it was a closure that I needed.
And I always, you know, I always, because I went through the same thing, and I think we can vibe on so many levels about, like, meeting our dads and having that relationship with our dads later on in life. It was one of those really, those real, because I do a lot of self-reflection. And in my reflection, I had asked myself, you know, if I was to get my dad, like, have my dad in my life the way I wanted him to be in my life when I was a kid, you know, what would I really get out of it at 20, 21 years old? You know, I'm not... At 9 years, you know, I'm not needing the same thing I needed when I was 9. So, I mean, yeah, definitely. It's one of those things, you know, it's tough. It's a reality. And I just know, like, for myself, and I'm pretty sure you can speak to it, you don't want your kids and your grandkids to go to through the same things you have, you know, or your mom has. So... Definitely.
No, because you become bitter, and I'm gonna be honest with you and straight up, you know, it made me turn out to be a cold-hearted person towards a lot of males, you know, because at one point, you know, I wanted to deal with, you know, the drug dealers, I wanted to deal with the players, you know what I mean, because they can buy me things and sweetheart me this and baby this and I love you this and I love you that, but all of that was temporary. You know what I mean? That wasn't real genuine love.
Yeah.
You know, but because I was getting that attention that I never received before as a little girl, you know, I was blind to a lot of things.
Right.
And you know what I mean? And the reason why I wanted to do that as far as having a relationship with my father now is just so that I could close the chapter to remain strong for my children.
Right. Right. And you have to remain consistent in their life so that, I mean, because right now, you're the only consistent thing they have. And
I
know that we're going to touch more on that. Well, actually, Esquire and Kia is going to touch on that on Sunday. They're talking about single parents on their Sunday show. So tune in to that as well, all the viewers and listeners.
Okay.
But yeah, Latrice, thank you so much for, you know, your testimonial and your perspective, because you're not alone, and so many people can identify with what you're communicating with us today. So we appreciate you.
Oh, you guys are very, very welcome, and I wish you guys nothing but success.
Thank you.
And
thank you.
Thank you for giving me a call and me speaking out. I hope that I was able to help others that can't speak or want to speak but is too shy to speak.
Yeah.
And God bless you all.
Thank you.
Right.
All right.
Before we move on, everybody, please, if you haven't seen it on our Facebooks already, April 27th, that is the deadline for you to order your Mother's Day T-shirts.
Pre-order.
T-shirts, short sleeve, long sleeve shirts, and hoodies. You can get them in any color, any size. And the prices, I believe, it was $15, $20, and $25. I believe, and if I'm wrong, I will repost it. But I believe it's $15 for t-shirts,
$20
for short sleeve, $20 for long sleeve, and $25 for the hoodies. I seen them, man. They tight, man. The design is on point. You know what I'm saying? You know. Black Tea, Brown Sugar, man, we wouldn't put nothing bad out there. And also, for an extra $5, you can also, whether it's your mother, you know, whether it's a loved one that passed away, you know, you can actually get their name, you know what I'm saying, engraved on the shirt to add to the design. So please, please, please go to Black Tea, Brown Sugar Facebook page. All the information will be on there. But just remember, you know, we do have a deadline, which is April 27th. If you can't get in touch with me or Ash, hit up our boy, Mr. Esquire himself. And you can contact him through the Black Tea Brown Sugar page. Just leave a comment, and he will definitely help y'all out. Actually, he just posted the information now. So it's at the bottom of the page right now. So
Mother's Day t-shirts on sale. Pre-order by April 27th. $20 for t-shirts. Oh, you were wrong. $25 for long sleeve and 30 for hoodies.
I'm sorry.
Place loved one's name on the shirt for $5.
Hey, Esquire almost shorted the money. So it's not $15. It's
a dove. And Naomi is posting.
It's a dove.
Naomi is posting.
A dove and a nickel.
So thank you, Naomi. So Alex says, so are we supposed to, well, he asks, so are we supposed to be their daddy?
It's not fair.
I'm looking at you as my spouse, but I have to discipline and put you in punishment too. Help me. Wait, okay. Like,
well, Alex, listen, if you could, Alex, we would like for you to call in so we could get to, because Alex isn't posting a lot. So if you could, Alex, text us right now, man, 412-376-5180.
And then you can pay for your Mother's Day shirt by clicking the donate button on the page.
Correct.
But yeah, it definitely, as far as the being the daddy, and because you see in certain relationships, and I have friends in the relationships, they're playing the daddy role to their women partners, and then their women partners are playing mommy role to them. I've seen it, and I'm not going to say it's not healthy. I'm not in that type of situation.
Right.
But what I will say is, you have to be able to grow with your spouse and realize where, not only where they are, but where they came from.
Correct.
And we all have baggage, and we all have things that we're carrying. And I mean, that's on an individual basis. You know from the jump when you start first dating the person on what you can and can't tolerate.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely. I mean, I don't condone the whole be the daddy, be the mommy in a relationship, because that is silly. That's okay. Not a relationship.
So right to a young brother that I know, a young brother that Ash knows. Am I doing this right?
No, you're not.
You handle it.
All right.
About to make a phone call because I'm very because we're talking about the role of a male. I really want to get brothers. Views on some of the things that we're talking about, man, because at the end of the day, you know, this is us. You know what I'm saying? This is us, man, you know. And we got to figure this out, man.
I think there's a connection issue.
Okay. Are we still on? Are we still live? Are we still live?
I don't know.
No, we're not live anymore.
Hello?
Hey, what's up?
What's going on?
Nothing. Stay on the line. You about to be on live real quick.
I'm cool. All right. I'm not going to warn me.
Well, you're not on air yet.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Duh.
No.
I think we're still live.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. I think we are still live.
I don't know, because it logs us up.
Yeah, we are still live.
Oh, we are?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
We just can't see nothing.
So right now, we have on the phone a brother, my brother. My baby brother.
He's not a baby. I need you to stop referring to him.
He's not a baby, but he's my baby brother. Okay. So I could call him my baby brother.
Hey, my Dante. Baby brother.
What's up, Dante? What's good, baby? Now, I said, what's going on?
Nothing, chilling, man. Doing what I do best.
Now, to let y'all know, my brother, he's not a cook, but he's a chef. He will be graduating very, very soon from culinary arts school. When you graduating, Dante?
End of the year.
End of the year. So, you know, I want y'all definitely congratulate. Pray for my little brother, you know what I'm saying? He will be graduating. So, Dante, I called you just because, you know, just because me and you growing up with each other. What we're talking about today, we're freezing a little bit. What we're talking about today, Dante, is what the role of the man is and the effects that the roles of a man have on the families, the children, just black societies in general. So when you hear the role of a man, what comes to mind?
Duke.
Me?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You was the man figure so in my life.
Oh, thank you, bro. I appreciate it, man. Well, you know, you're a man too, man. You know, watching everything that you do, the accomplishments, you know what I'm saying, your gift, watch you mastering your craft, man. You know what I'm saying? I look at you as the role of a man too, man. You, come on, man. Y'all making me cry on this show, man. Y'all touching a brother's heart. So let me ask you this, Dante. What do you feel like? Do you feel like a lot of men today are carrying out what the role of a man should be?
No.
Okay, could you elaborate on it a little bit?
Everybody live for themselves.
Yeah, I agree with that.
My men ain't, you know, really taking care of their responsibilities.
Word.
You see stuff on social media every day how a man, a supposedly man, that really don't care about the town or the mother of their child.
Right. Well, I agree. That's deep, man. You know what I'm saying? That's very true. You know, I feel like, you know what? It does seem like a lot of these fathers out here is kind of like, I'm going to do me, that whole do me mentality.
And that, I mean, that's because they lack example. I mean, I can count on my hand how many men I know that are actually involved in their children's lives. I mean, I was blessed to have an uncle that definitely cared.
Yeah.
Like, he definitely assumed the role of my dad. He wasn't my dad, he was my uncle. But, like, he definitely stepped in, you know. He took us, me and my sister, to, like, Kennywood. He did the ice cream dates. He did the, you know.
Right.
He was definitely there. So, yeah, I mean, it's just unfortunate that so many men are like, man, I offered you, give you the $300. You know what I mean? Like, and it's unfortunate because it's like, it's tough. I mean, I really don't have too much to say. Mm. I mean, because it's heartbreaking. And somebody had mentioned the hurt.
Hold up. All right. Real quick. Hold up. Uh-oh. My daughter is watching. She said, hi, Daddy. Hi. What's up, girl? Hey, baby. And your Uncle Dante said hi, too.
Dante still on the line?
Yeah. Oh, man. She was supposed to be here today. You know what I'm saying? But, my baby's watching. Now, Pam Owens, well, first, let me do Aaron first. Dante, are you busy? Do we need to let you go?
I could talk a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll give you a call back, though, okay?
All right.
All right. Okay. Thanks, Dante.
All right. Aaron said, what's up, Aaron? What's good, man? He said, I do not think men know what their role is. Aaron, I honestly, I don't.
That is a fact.
I agree, man. I don't think a lot of cats know, period. Pam Owens, what's up, Pam? Pam said, dads are important physically and spiritually in other ways, too. We women were/are never meant nor meant to play both roles, and that is real. We were designed different for a... Let me make sure I got somebody's calling in.
Hello. You're on the air. Hello?
I think that's S.
He ain't saying nothing.
Can you hear him?
No.
All right, we'll probably try to call him back. But to finish Pam's, what she said, we were designed different for a reason. God bless all of the good fathers out there. You are necessary. Thank you, Pam. I really, and that's the biggest thing that I think a lot of these brothers is missing. You know, that father not being in the household, you know what I'm saying, is taken away from the full package that a child is supposed to get. You know what I'm saying? me and my child's mother, you know, what we do is we strategically sit down and plan how we're going to do certain things as far as how she's going to handle certain stuff, how I'm going to handle certain stuff. Now, my daughter, she's a good little girl. She's sweet as she can be. But she likes to talk like her daddy. You know what I'm saying? She got a mouth like her daddy. So, you know, sometimes, you know, me and her mother, you know what I'm saying, we'll have to deal with her in different ways, you know what I'm saying? You know, me as daddy, you know what I'm saying, I pretty much, you know what I'm saying, got to give my daughter just that look. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, you better chill out. You know what I'm saying? Because there's two women in the house. You know what I'm saying? My daughter's mom, you know what I'm saying, you know, she might got to get a little, hold up, little girl. I'm the queen of the house. You're going to respect me. I'm your mother. This is what I told you to do. You know what I'm saying? We really haven't had to do that with my daughter for real, but we have had our moments and stuff where, you know, my daughter might have not been doing something, not been listening, you know what I'm saying? And my daughter's mother might have had to call me and be like, she cutting up, I'm going to need you to get her, you know what I'm saying? She knows that if she got to call daddy, you know what I'm saying, then, and it's really going to be a problem because men, you know what I'm saying, it's not about us putting fear on our children's heart, but it is about, you know what I'm saying, us standing as men knowing you don't cross, you know what I'm saying, your parents, and a man, the children need to see that we as men are supposed to be the support and the backbone for the mother. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm my daughter, you know what I'm saying, I've never had to spank my daughter, but just the thought of me spanking her and her mad is enough. You know what I'm saying? So for my daughter's mom to use that, you know what I'm saying? That's part of, you know what I'm saying, us working together, you know what I'm saying? That's why it's important, you know what I'm saying, to have that, you know, just that bond.
And I else? Mean, unfortunately, we're going to have to wrap this up.
I know.
Such a good topic.
Such a good
topic. I'm glad everybody joined in and tuned in. We're definitely going to be back in 2 weeks, not next Friday, but the Friday after with another great topic.
Yes.
Definitely, we're going to continue on this conversation on Sunday. So definitely tune in at 7 o'clock, same time, same place, Sunday.
Yep.
And definitely don't forget about those t-shirts.
Right.
So the t-shirts, what's the price?
20, 25, 35, 45. No, I'm just playing.
That's not the price.
t-shirts are $20. Long sleeve shirts are $25, and the hoodies are $30. And for an additional $5, you can get a loved one's name integrated on your shirt. I wish I had some shirts now to show, but if you go on the page, actually, the shirts are posted up on the page, so you can actually see them there. They're actually the profile picture for the Black Tea Brown Sugar page, so go ahead and check them out. Like I said, they come in all sizes, all colors. You know, I'm not...
Definitely a good Mother's Day tribute gift.
Yeah, especially if for those that have any mothers that lost. I mean, for those that lost any mothers or anything.
Grandmothers, yeah.
You know, it's definitely a great gift. Uh-oh, wait a minute.
My mom?
Esquire said, yeah, your mama is on. Your mama's on.
My mom's on. Hey, Mom.
Hi. But Esquire said $5 off tonight only.
Tonight only, so yes.
So, if you call now, $15, $20, $25. T-shirts, $15. Long sleeves, $20. And hoodies, $25. We get it $5 off tonight. You know
Esquire must be fit. This must have been a victory.
Yeah.
For his Friday.
Yeah, and don't, you know... Black people, don't ask us for more discounts because we black. You know what I'm saying?
So
listen,
funny.
The money that y'all put so into this, let me explain something. Black Tea Brown Sugar, you know what I'm saying? This is a non-profit organization. It's not just about us getting in here talking about these things. There's going to be other things in store. You know what I'm saying? And one of the things that we are going to be doing is serving and supporting the community. So the money that you put into this black-owned, imagine you hear what I said, this is a black-owned company. The money that you put into this is going to be put to good use. You
and
know,
going back into the community.
Exactly.
So we need you to help us help you.
Exactly.
So definitely, please support. You can donate if you don't necessarily want a t-shirt.
Please.
You can always just donate.
Click that donate button.
Yes, and the link is provided on the Facebook page. Definitely, we thank you for your support. We thank you for the love, the encouragement. We have the victory in Christ.
Yes, we do.
Definitely. Tune in 2 weeks. Tune in this Sunday. Great topics.
Every Sunday at that.
And we're looking to broaden out. So, you know, promoting, advertising. We do live interviews. We do video casting. This is what we're doing. We're networking. We want to educate, equip, and inspire.
That's
so
right.
If that sounds like something you want to do, join Black Tea Brown Sugar.
Right.
All right.
And also, make sure y'all also reach out to the Black Tea Brown Sugar Instagram page. And also, you can reach me on Instagram at Hey_Mr_Marcus, and you can also reach me on Twitter at Hi_Mr_Marcus. Especially if you guys want to be on the show, t-shirts, anything y'all need, and y'all can hit up Ash at.
I'm Ashley R. Smith on Facebook, first of all. And then, I'm Ashley R. Smith, and then on Instagram and Twitter, I'm Ashers1115, Ashers1115. Hey, you guys, thank you again so much. Have a blessed, safe, good weekend. Stay warm. It's still cold in Pittsburgh. Unfortunately, we actually had snow in Pittsburgh today. But it's supposed to be a good weather week, so.
Yeah, peace and love, baby. All Enjoy right. y'all weekend. Stay safe.
Real.